So morning, everybody. My name is Dan Peterson. I'm a product manager for Google Wave, primarily focused on the platform APIs and the underlying federation protocol. So glad to have everybody here today. It's a big crew. We got a lot of stuff we can hopefully hack on. It's definitely been a wild ride over the last 7 weeks. I think we've seen a lot of people experimenting and prototyping with some of the APIs we have available. We've also given out more than 6,000 accounts at this point, and we have 20,000 more requests in the pipe we're working through over in the next month or so. We've also heard a lot of feedback about the general usability of Wave itself, as well as sort of people who are starting to grok the Wave model. Certainly things are very early with Wave in particular, so we're open to lots of feedback and are iterating as we go. We just want to involve everybody else as we iterate to make this the best platform possible. So general flow for the day, well, and general flow for the day, we have David will be giving an API overview shortly, and then Marcel will come up and do a tutorial about the Java Robots API, and then we'll take a quick break for lunch and bathroom breaks and that kind of thing, and then we'll do a panel for Q&A about the APIs and maybe Google Wave in general if you have questions like that. One logistical note, if you don't already have your accounts, where's Alan? So first of all, double check your spam folders because everybody in this room should have gotten accounts. Alan Green was standing over there, but maybe he is, oh, there you go. Alan over there in the blue shirt. If you don't yet have your accounts, hunt down Alan later, he's friendly. Let's see. At the end of the day, after we sort of get into hacking time, we'll have some time for people to demo what they've been building, some of the earlier prototypes and that kind of thing. So just as a heads up for that, we'll have beer arrive and that kind of thing. So next up, we actually have Lars Rasmussen joining us from Sydney for a quick announcement. Note it is 3 a.m. in Sydney.
Yes, hello. Good morning. There you are. Hello, good morning. Don't actually have anything to say. I think Dan just really liked the idea of me being up until 3 in the morning.
You said you were going to be in pajamas.
I was going to be. Oh, I'm wearing pajamas. You just can't. The camera's just zooming in too much. So, no, you guys, welcome. Thanks for coming. I know it's a lot of your time to come here for a full Monday. I wanted to just share a little bit about our short-term plans for Wave. So you guys are all on a Wave sandbox as part of our developer preview. On September 30th, so in a little bit more than 2 months, we're going to move our preview from that separate sandbox build onto the main Wave index on wave.google.com that we're actually using now for dog food and inside of Google. And then we're going to extend the scope of the preview beyond developers. So we'll invite around about 100,000 users, starting, of course, with you guys. By then, we'll have some tens of thousands of developers in the sandbox. But we have a lot of requests from wave.google.com for people that offer to help file bugs and so on. And so we'll invite them on board so that we'll have around about 100,000 users starting on September 30th. And what we're going to spend our time on between now and then is three things. Well, four, actually. It's speed. You have noticed if you've tried the sandbox that we've carefully avoided the trap of premature optimization. So we're going to be working on that a lot. It's reliability. We are going to, roughly speaking, taking it from the alpha level quality that you're feeling now to something more like a beta, so that mostly you'll be able to get through a day's work without any crashes. And then usability. There's a good deal of usability problems that you guys are facing, in particular how to keep your inbox calm and useful. And so those are the things we'll work on. And one of the reasons that we're sharing this, we don't normally do this at Google. We don't normally share plans for the future and so on. But one of the things we learned from back in the Maps days was that in particular, when you want to get developers involved, which we obviously do, it's a helpful thing to share future plans. So we hope we'll do well with this, and we need your help as well. We'd like to be able to, by September 30th, maybe highlight some of the things that you guys are building. And so we've started seeing some early examples of what people have built with Wave, and it's very exciting and so on. But they tend, of course, this is still very early, to be fairly small in scope. And so we're looking forward, of course, to seeing really ambitious things. We like to think that Wave can be used to build really, big and meaningful collaborative applications. And if you guys are planning something like that, so beyond what you can build in a few days, let Dan and his team know, and maybe we'll feature your extension or your site embedding Waves as part of this this little thing of extending the preview at the end of September. So I want to say, we have done a few of these hackathons, and I always emphasize that that we want you guys to be really ambitious, and we want you guys also to be demanding of us. We want that if you build a site that embeds Waves, then the Waves should feel like a natural part of your site. And if you build extensions for Wave, then those extensions should feel to the Wave user as if they were a first-class citizen, a native part of Wave. And we know that we don't have all of the hooks in place in the APIs to do this. And so whenever you find yourself building something that feels a little clunky, it doesn't quite feel like it's part of Wave, or it doesn't quite feel like the Wave is part of your site, let us know. Help us construct the right APIs to make this possible. I know Dan and his team loves nothing more than demanding developers wanting more. Right, Dan?
Absolutely.
Thank you. So we're also going to work on... of course, on the API, we're going the actual installation flow for user installing the extension. I think we just today actually put some more code in the sandbox for that, but we'll work more on that. We'll also build a gallery-like experience so that users can find the extensions without necessarily having to have them shared in a way with them. And the last thing I want to just mention, so we get asked this a lot about monetization. So we're keen to make Wave a viable business, both for us and for you guys. And one thing that many people have suggested is whether we could build some sort of application store where you guys could find different ways of monetizing the things that you build. And this is something we're thinking about. I don't have anything to announce. I just want you guys to know that it is something we're thinking about. And with that, I'll hand it back to Dan. You guys have a great time hacking through the day. Who knows, maybe I will be awake again by the time you guys end. Thank you.
Good night, Lars.
Indeed. Thank you.